We're talking with Doug Somerville from the Department of Industry and Investment, New South Wales, about American foulbrood. Doug, how do you know if you have American foulbrood in your hide?
The certain symptoms and signs and symptoms we're looking for in the brood, so we need to inspect that brood to determine whether we've got the disease. In this case, we've got a double beehive. I know in this particular hive we have a light infection, or we have a significant infection disease. So we'll go into the hive and just inspect it to have a look at those symptoms to become familiar with what are the signs we're looking for. Bit of a light smoke. Give the gap between the frames quite large. And again, if you need to wear glasses, this is the time to put them on if you haven't already done so. So there's not too many bees in this hive, but we can just shake the bees off, make it a bit easier. So in this case, I'm looking at the pattern, which is not too bad, but the cappings are very dark and they're fairly sunken. In a lot of cases, the cappings are chewed with little holes in them. So there's a lot of indications here that things are not right. So there's a lot of dead larvae as well in the bases of the cells. And there's actually scale in this. So this comb here is heavily infected with disease, American foulbrood. There are some healthy bees in there, but not too many. So this particular comb is pretty well, nearly 100% infected with American foulbrood. So the main symptoms I'm looking for are the off-coloured cappings. They're a bit brown or chocolate brown in colour. They're sunken, a bit greasy, and in this case they're chewed around a little bit. When the brood is not that advanced in the disease, it'll string out a rope, so we'll get it to rope. So to do a rope test is quite a common test to determine whether we've got early stages of the disease. As the larvae dries out, you won't get it to rope, but in the early stages of the disease, you will get it to rope out. So if we put the match into what we think is an infected cell and just rope it out, we'll get it to rope out in this case. So it's very slimy coming out of the base of the cell. Just about all of these cells are infected. So there's absolutely no doubt at all that this hive has American foulbrood. It's a very slimy consistency. Well, that was the healthy one. It's healthy. This is diseased.
What are the advanced symptoms of the disease?
This comb or this hive is very advanced in the disease, but in an advanced case you can also have a very strong odour when you open a beehive and just generally smell the condition of the hive. They have a very distinct odour associated with the disease. It's fairly hard to describe or compare it to anything really your common variety of odours.
Are the symptoms of American foulbrood similar to any other diseases?
It is possible to have the early stages of the disease looking a bit like European foulbrood. In some cases, chalk brood, the cappings can be sunken and darkened as well, with the chalk brood fungal infection affecting the larvae behind the capping and causing similar symptoms to this. But this is very obviously American foulbrood because you've got a number of symptoms in this comb. You've got the sunken dark cells, you've got the cappings chewed, you've got the ropiness of the larvae as well. So in this particular comb, it's very obvious. We can go to another hive and have a look at it and just look at some scale in relation to the disease. So it's an advanced case and we see if we can find some early stages of the disease in another hive. This particular hive, it's fairly weak. You can see in this case, there's not a lot of brood that's obvious as far as capping is concerned, So the casual observer say, well, there's a bit of honey here, a bit of pollen stored around there, a bit more honey about there. But otherwise, and there's a fair bit of fresh nectar in that cone, you can possibly see the glisten to that. I don't know whether we can get it shaken out. No, we can't. But if you look at the base of that particular cell, a lot of those cells there have disease in them. So looking at scale from here, I can see literally hundreds and hundreds of scale. So these bees have actually uncapped the diseased brood, removed the cappings, but they haven't been able to remove the scale. So it's another symptom of disease. In an advanced case where the disease has been around for some months, you'll see an excess amount of scale on the base of the cell. Now it's critical that you look at the cells from the top of the bar down into the base of the cell. If I look at it from that angle, I can't see the scale, and likewise if I look at it with the top bar away from me, I can't see the scale. So it's important to hold the frame with the top bar in your hands, just rotating it so you can visualize the scale on the base of the cell.